Back to the future, but I'm back. I'm back from the future.
Great Scott!
Well, well, well. After 1 year of silence, I'm back. And I bring some very exciting news about Gevo. For those who might not have been following the latest developments, Gevo just made a massive move that could transform its path to profitability sooner than any of us expected. And yes, you heard that right. Profitability by 2025. Before diving into the news, I want to take a moment to explain why I've been away for so long. And to be honest, I've been quite disappointed with the lack of progress on the Net Zero One project. Despite a groundbreaking ceremony full of promise 2 years ago, nothing has really happened since. It felt like the project was just being pushed further and further into the future, which really dampened my enthusiasm. But today's news has completely reignited my confidence. For the first time in a while, I see the leadership showing the kind of strategic decisiveness and problem solving that can actually bring this vision to life. Now, let's get back to the exciting news at hand.
Red Trail Energy is a corn-based biorefinery located near Richardton, North Dakota. This state-of-the-art plant began producing ethanol in January of 2007. Today, Red Trail Energy produces around 65 million gallons of ethanol, using 23 million bushels of corn annually. That equates to 2.85 gallons of ethanol from every bushel of corn. Red Trail Energy is the first carbon capture and storage project allowed under state primacy in the United States. Red Trail Energy has taken action on something others only talk about. We're setting a new standard for the ethanol industry by capturing 100% of our CO2 emissions created by the fermentation process. The CO2 is permanently stored underground more than a mile below the surface in the Broom Creek Formation. Utilizing state-of-the-art monitoring technology, we can monitor CO2 plume in real time. This allows us to not only be better stewards to the environment, but also places more value on the ethanol in the clean fuel market.
First off, Gevo is about to add a major low-carbon ethanol production asset to its portfolio, which will significantly ramp up their ability to produce net zero fuels. But wait, it gets better. The CCS facility, which has been operating since 2022, is currently capturing 160,000 metric tons of carbon per year, which directly contributes to reducing the CI score, or carbon intensity, of ethanol. More carbon captured means lower CI ethanol, which in turn makes Gevo's fuels even more attractive in carbon-regulated markets.
With a total of 48 employees, Red Trail Energy manages to operate 24 hours a day. This project is the first of its kind here in North Dakota and the first in the nation when it comes to the modern day technology and equipment that they use.
What it does is for us, it actually lowers our carbon intensity value of our ethanol, which in turn gives it a higher value and a bigger return for our shareholders.
So what happens to CO2 trapped underground? Over time, CO2 often chemically reacts with minerals from the surrounding rock. The elements bind to create solid chalky minerals, essentially locking the CO2 into the rock in a process called mineral storage. One study published in the journal Nature suggests more than 98% of injected CO2 will remain stored for more than 10,000 years.
Here's the kicker. By acquiring Red Trail Energy's assets, Gevo expects to turn adjusted EBITDA positive by 2025. And this is massive because, let's be honest, Gevo's stock price has been quite devastating to follow the last couple of years. But with this acquisition, combined with their RNG business and other revenue streams, the company is positioning itself to be profitable, a key milestone that really could restore investor confidence. Gevo's Net Zero One project in South Dakota is the heart of their strategy, and the Red Trail acquisition is a perfect fit. Not only does it secure a low-carbon ethanol supply, but it also brings a wholly owned CCS site that will provide critical sequestration capacity for future projects. Essentially, this acquisition helps de-risk the Net Zero One project by ensuring Gevo has the infrastructure and the expertise to handle large-scale carbon capture operations. Another important aspect is how well this acquisition positions Gevo to serve key low carbon fuel markets in the US and Canada, including places like Oregon, Washington, and British Columbia. These are regions that offer premium prices for low carbon fuels. So adding Red Trail's low CI ethanol into the mix means Gevo can tap into these high demand markets more effectively. What does this mean for Gevo's stock and overall business? In the short term, we might not see an immediate jump in the stock price. It might take some time, even though we had quite a fantastic run the same day the news was published. However, this acquisition is setting up the infrastructure and cash flow that will not only drive profitability, self-sufficiency, and will also be a training ground for the Net Zero One project. So, my dear followers, after a few rough years, things are starting to look up. With this acquisition, Gevo has put itself on the fast track to profitability. And by next year, 2025, we might just see a completely transformed company ready to dominate the net zero fuel market.
I think it's safe to say that our luck has officially turned around, guys. We are back, baby. We are fucking back.
We're back. Yeah. Classic.
We are back. That's we are back.
I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions on this acquisition. Do you guys think it's the game changer Gevo needed? Let me know in the comments below. Let's get the conversation going. And just a reminder, my videos are for informational and entertainment purposes only and should not be taken as any kind of financial advice. If you found this update helpful, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. And I really hope I can find the time and motivation to keep bringing you updates on Gevo here on my YouTube channel. Bye bye, until next time.